Estamos con un 4-1-2-1-2, porque Montero se quedaba libre, por tanto, interior por izquierda.
Hi everyone, good evening. Welcome.
Hi,
good evening.
Nice to see you. And now you can see me. Hoy sí me pueden ver. Now you can see me. Yesterday was terrible, right? Ayer sí nos dio problemas. Everything.
Andaba de creída, no quería que la viéramos.
Yes.
In
Zoom.
English.
Zoom didn't want you to see me. I'm going to take the attendance, okay, so we can start the class. Give me 1 second. So we start with Ana Beatriz. Ana Lilian.
Present teacher.
Thank you. Blanca. Alvarenga.
Present teacher. Present.
Brian. Javier. Carlos Antonio.
Present.
Okay, thank you, Carlos. Francisca Elizabeth.
Present, teacher. Okay.
Frida Mejía. José Galileo.
Present.
Okay. José Rodrigo. Laura Carolina. Luis Alfonso.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. María Concepción.
Present.
Okay. María Elena. María Ivania. Nelson Gavarrete.
I'm here, miss.
Okay. Omar Francisco. Oscar Arnulfo.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Zaira Larín. Wendy Zabaleta. Jenny Santos.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Wendy. Then let's continue with Christian Lazo.
Present, miss.
Okay. José Arnoldo.
Present, miss.
Okay. José Jonathan. Juan Carlos. And Mayra Moreno. Okay. Now we can continue. We will start the class with one activity. I'm going to share with you the screen, the whiteboard, and I'm going to annotate some information that we will use. Maybe you've done this before. Okay, the idea is that we are going to try to remember different vocabulary. I'm going to tell you a letter and you have to think about the next categories. You have to think about an object. Let me just fix it like this. An object with that letter, a city or country with that letter, a verb in English with that letter, animal, and food. Example, let's imagine that we select letter B and you have to think about an object that starts with letter B. Maybe banana. Okay, now what about a country or a city with letter B? Brazil. And then a verb with the verb B. I'm sorry, with B. We can use B. And then an animal. An animal, bird, and food. It could be banana again. Okay? That is what you have to do. When you finish, say stop. Cuando acaben todas las categorías, tienen que decir stop. El primero que termine dice stop. Understood? ¿Sí está claro? Yes? No? Galileo,
yes.
No.
Yes, teacher.
No.
Yes.
Okay. Galileo.
It's a bachelor stop.
Sorry, teacher.
Stop the bus. Correct. Galileo, yo les voy a dar una letra. I will assign a letter. And you have to think about different things. Y usted tiene que, one moment. Usted tiene que pensar en un object que empiece con la letra que les doy. Si yo dijera C, tiene que ser un object con letter C. Una city or country con eso. Y todo lo que está ahí con esa letra. Ok. And if you finish, you say stop. Cuando alguien termine, dice stop. Ok.
Entonces, teacher.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Teacher,
pregunta.
Yes.
¿Sería la misma letra para todos o va a dar una por cada uno?
The same letter for everyone. Todos la misma. Solo este era un ejemplo. Just for you to have an idea. Ok. Now we will start. Letter. Hold on.
Good evening, teacher.
Hi, Zaira. Good evening. Vamos a jugar la versión de inglés de bachillerato Stop. Se llama Stop the Bus. Entonces yo voy ahorita a darles una letra y ustedes tienen que llenar las categories que aparecen aquí en la whiteboard. Si termina, dice stop. Ok, letter M. M.
Stop.
Okay, excellent. Arnoldo, tell us, object with M?
Mirror.
Mm-hmm. City or country?
Morocco.
Okay, verb?
Make.
Animal,
monkey.
Mm-hmm. Monkey. And food?
Melon.
Uh-huh. Excellent, Arnoldo. Very good. Tell me a letter, please. Dígame una letra. One letter.
A D.
D, as in David. Okay, letter D.
Yes.
Stop.
Okay, very good. Let's see. Tell us the object. The object.
Diamond.
Mayra. Diamond. Okay. City or country?
Dinamarca.
Mm-hmm. Dinamarca. And verb?
Do.
Animal?
Dinosaur.
Dinosaur. Food?
Rayos, eso se me olvidó, teacher, por Dios.
Ah, okay. So, guys, you still Donut. Have... Ah, okay. So, there you go. Donut. That could be food. Okay, Mayra, tell us the next letter, please.
P.
Okay, letter P. Hello, Elena. Welcome. We're playing the English version of Bachillerato Stop. It's stop the yes. bus in English. Try to complete. Try to complete.
Okay.
If you finish, say stop.
Okay.
Stop.
Okay, very well. That was fast. Can you tell us the object with letter P?
Pencil.
City or country?
Peru.
Verb.
Boat.
Animal.
Pelican.
Mm-hmm. Food. Pizza.
Beer, pizza.
Ah, pear. Yes, that's a good one. Very good, Oscar. Very fast. A letter, Oscar. One more letter. The last one.
C.
C. C. But I use that one. Choose another one. A different one.
Letter B.
B. B as in baby.
Yes.
I use that one too. Ya la usamos. Next.
Letter C.
Letter C.
Okay.
Yes.
Stop. Okay, Wendy. Good. Tell us the object, please.
Candy.
Uh-huh. City or country?
Canada.
Mm-hmm. Verb?
Come.
Animal?
Cat.
And food?
Candy.
And candy too. Congratulations, you did well, Wendy. This is like a vocabulary exercise for you to remember different words that you know. But now we will continue. I'm going to first share the book. This is something that we started to do yesterday, right? Today we have presentations. We will have the presentations about this. But we will have a fluency exercise. I am going to read one paragraph. And some of you have to do it at the same speed as me. Vamos a hacer un ejercicio de fluidez. Yo voy a leer lo primero, un párrafo. Voy a tomarme el tiempo y luego algunos de ustedes tienen que hacerlo también a la misma velocidad que yo. Okay, at the same pace as me. Okay, that is the activity with one paragraph. Okay, we will start with this one. Okay, you are familiar with the words, and I'm going to keep track of the time. One second. Let me get it here. Okay. Be a people person. North South is people, and we are looking for managers who like people. You should be comfortable with conflict resolution. You should know how people work and know how to motivate your team. If you are better with computers than people and understand Klingon better than English, you are not a good fit for our managerial team. 31 seconds. Okay, that's my time, and that should be your time too. Okay, is there a volunteer who would like to go first? ¿Hay algún voluntario que quiera ir primero?
Me, teacher.
Okay, mm-hmm. Galileo. Let's begin with you in that case. On the count of three. La cuenta de tres. One, two, three.
Be a people person. Dumpster is people, and we are looking for managers who like people. You should be comfortable with conflict resolution. You should know how people work and know how to motivate your team. If you are better with computers than people and understand Clinton better than English, you are not a good fit for our managerial team.
Very well. Look at your time. 27 seconds. Okay, so outstanding. Very well. Thank you. Okay, who else says, said me? ¿Escuché a alguien más? Who said me besides Galileo? If not, I can choose. Omar.
Me, teacher.
Omar. Ah, okay, yes. Omar. On the count of three. One, two, three.
Be a people person. Nurse is people. We are looking for manager who like people. You should be comfortably be with conflict resolution. You should know how people work and knew how to motivate your team. If you are very with computer that people and understand English better than English, you are not a good fit for our manager team.
Thank you. Look at the time. 36 seconds, Oscar. One more time. Let's do it one more time. Let's improve that score. Vamos a hacerlo otra vez, Omar. Hay que bajar el score. Ready again? On the count of three. One, two, three.
Be a people person. Nurse is people, and we are looking for manager.
Let's do it again, Omar. On the count of three. One, two, three.
Be a people person. Nurse is people, and we are looking for manager. We like people. You should be comfortable with conflict resolution. You should know how people work and know how to motivate your team. If you are very with computer, that people understand English better than English, you are not a good fit for our manager team.
Okay, thank you, Omar. This is the score now, 41 seconds. We have to lower it. I'm going to give you time for you to practice it, Omar, and then we check again. I'm going to help you with some words. This one here, Omar, motivate. Please repeat. Motivate.
Motivate.
Mm-hmm. Managerial.
Managerial. Managerial.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Uh-huh. We will try later, but continue practicing, Omar. Okay, Elena, let's continue with you. Paragraph number two. Okay, we will check paragraph number two. Me first, and then it will be your turn. All right, so be a good communicator. You should be able to communicate effectively using all methods, including visual presentations, public speaking, email, teleconferencing, and face-to-face. Good communication is a two-way street. You will be required to routinely update your employees on their and the team's performance. You will communicate any feedback from upper management and customers and provide status information when asked. Okay, 39 seconds, Elena. That's the score. Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Okay, 1, 2, 3.
Be a good communicator. You should be able to communicate it effectively using all methods, including visual presentation, public speaking, email, teleconferencing, and face-to-face. Good communication is a two-way street. You will be required to routinely update your employees on their team's performance. You will communicate and feedback from upper management and customers. Provide status information when asked.
Look, very well. You have the same score as me. Okay, very well. Thank you. Now, Wendy, I got you. The message here. You're next, Wendy.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Be a good communicator. Mm-hmm. Be a good communicator. You should be able to communicate effectively using all methods, including visual presentation, public speaking, emails, teleconferencing, and face-to-face. Good communication is a two-way street. You will be required to frequently update your employees on their and the team's performance. You will communicate any feedback from upper management and customers and provide status information when I school.
Okay, congratulations. 37 seconds. Yo y aquí va, y rápido. But yes, you did it very well. Thank you. Just this word, the one you see here is teleconferencing. Just say it in that way, teleconferencing. Okay, and just that, then it was very well. Okay, I'm going to choose another person. Let's try with Alfonso. Okay, Alfonso, let's go with you. 41 seconds, Alfonso, that's the score. Second paragraph. Are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, go.
Be a good communicator. You should be able to communicate effectively using all methods, including visual presentation, public speaking, email, teleconferencing, and face-to-face. Good communication is a two-way street. You will be required to routinely update your employee on their and the team's performance. You will communicate any feedback from upper management and customer and provide status information when asking.
Very well. Look, 32 seconds. So you did it like 9 seconds faster than me. So very well. This word, Alfonso, is asked. That's the correct way to say. Mm-hmm. Ask.
Yes. Okay, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Now, number three. Let's go with be technically proficient. We will continue with this one. Okay, so it says, be technically proficient. The products we create at Norxod are technically complicated. You don't need to be able to code in C, but you should be able to give technical guidance and decide the best strategies and methods for success. And not having watched Happy Feet or The March of the Penguins does not qualify you as a technically proficient in Linux. Okay, 33 seconds. Let me take a look to the one who will be next. Maria Concepcion, let's try with you. 33 okay, seconds, teacher. Maria Concepcion. On the count of three.
Okay.
One, two, three.
the technical proficiency. The products we create at Northsoft are technical complicated. You don't need to be able to code in C, but you should be able to give technical guidance and decide the best strategies and methods for success. And not having watched Happy Eat Feet or the March of the Penguins does not qualify you as technical proficient in Linux.
Okay, thank you, Maria Concepcion. 36 seconds. I did 31, right? 31 seconds. You have to lower it a little bit. Vamos a hacerlo una vez más, Maria Concepcion. 31 seconds on the count of three. 1, 2, 3.
Be technical proficient. The products we write at Norson are technical complicated. You don't need to be able to code it in C, but you should be able to help technical guidance and decide the best strategies and methods for success and not having watched Happy Feet or the March of the Penguins does not qualify to as technical proficient in Linux.
Mm-hmm. 27 seconds now. Okay, so it was better. I'm going to help you with some words, the ones I underline. This one is able. Guidance. That's the pronunciation of this one. Decide. And this one here, strategies. Can you try, Maria Concepcion, one more time?
Oh, trying, sir, como fue, teacher?
Guidance. Uh-huh. Guidance. Can you repeat the other ones? The one here. ¿Puedes decir las
nuevamente
otras? Ajá. Solo las que están marcadas.
Me dijo Carmen.
Ajá.
Ok. Ahorita. Me dijo Able. Guidance.
Mm-hmm.
Advice.
Decide.
Mm-hmm. Y strategies. No.
Strategies.
Yes.
Strategies. Yes.
Strategies.
Yes.
Okay.
That's the pronunciation. Okay. Is there any other volunteer for this exercise? We still have time for one more person. Is there someone who would like to try? Or should I choose the next one? Volunteers? No? Okay, so Jenny, one, let's go with the next one, Jenny. The one here, okay, I will do it first and then you will do it. Encourage teamwork. That's the one we will do. Okay, one second. It says, encourage teamwork. Encourage teamwork. Teamwork is important at NorCSOT. Not only you are required to encourage the best practices for building teamwork, you are considered a part of the team. We have no doors at NorCSOT for you to hide behind. In fact, we have no traditional office space for managers. You are required to sit and work with your staff. Okay, 31 seconds. That's my score, Jenny. Ready?
Okay.
Go.
Yes. Requires teamwork. Teamwork is important at NorCSOT. Not only are you required to encourage the best practice for building teamwork, you are considered a part of the team. We have no doors at Norton for you to hide behind. In fact, we have no traditional office space for managers. You are required to sit and work with your staff.
Mm-hmm. 30 seconds. Very well. So 1 second less than me. Okay, it's a little exercise for you to speak, right? And to read in a good pace. We will continue with the presentations, okay? We have some presentations pending. Vamos a seguir con las presentations. Are you all ready? No sé si todos están ready o necesitan like a minute para hablar con sus compañeros en un room o empezamos ya.
1 minute, teacher.
1 minute just to like gather the ideas, solo para que vean cómo lo van a hacer. Okay, creo que no están justamente todos, right? Algunos sí. Let me see. Okay, Ivania, are you here, Ivania? Ivania, hello, were you working with Nelson, Omar, and Jenny? ¿Sí estaban ustedes cuatro? Yes?
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, so I'm going to create the rooms. First, we have Ivania, Omar, Jenny, and Nelson. Okay, then I have Jose Rodrigo and Luis Alfonso. Are you here, Rodrigo? Okay, yes, Rodrigo and Alfonso are here, right? Okay, Rodrigo and Alfonso. Next, Maria Concepcion, Mayra, and Oscar. Okay, we are here. Next one, number 5, Galileo. And then we have in the next room, let me see.
Wendy and Carlos.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Carlos, I think.
Uh-huh. Juan Carlos is not here. And Wendy, sí, Wendy está acá. Okay. Next one, Ana Beatriz. Frida is not here. Ana Beatriz and Elena. You're going to work with Elena. And then Blanca, you were working with Carlos, but he's not here. Laura and Zaira. Okay. Am I missing someone? ¿Me falta alguien? ¿De los de ayer? No. Okay, please.
Yo falta, teacher, yo no estuve ayer porque tuve una conexión. Lili.
Ah, Lili. Okay, los que no estaban ayer, vamos a hacer algo distinto in the meantime. You can, the others, you can accept the invite. Okay, Lili. Lili, me mencionabas que no se oía nada, ¿verdad? De la clase, creo.
No, es que entré del celular porque no tenía inter. En el wifi se había dañado, entonces entré del celular, pero no escuchaba nada de lo que estaban hablando.
Ajá. Ajá. Yes, I remember you sent me a message. Sí, recuerdo que leí el mensaje. Okay, entonces acá estamos los que... Bueno, Wendy, did you receive the notification for the room?
Okay. Teacher, yo no estaba ayer.
Uh-huh. Vamos a trabajar en es algo que... distinto, in the meantime. Ajá, sí, él.
No. No.
Okay.
Miss Evelyn. Then...
Uh-huh. Yes, Christian.
I will be... just listener because
of the accident.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Don't worry, okay? You can just listen to the class. I will consider okay. that.
Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm. Okay, de ahí Carlos is not here in this moment. Then Nelson, pasó algo que lo veo acá. Se salió del room.
No, no me mandó, no me mandó. No me sí. mandó la solicitud.
Voy a volvérsela a enviar.
Ah, pero quizás en un momento me sacó. Ok, gracias.
One moment. I will tell you in one moment. Ok. In the meantime, this is what we will do. ¿Verdad? Como ayer no estuvieron, no los pude tomar en cuenta para la presentation. But you can work on this. Pueden trabajar en esto. Based on the reading, you have to say if the statements are true or false. Hay unas oraciones que hay que ver si son verdaderas o falsas. Based on the reading, basados en lo que, en esto que acabamos de leer, tienen que contestar si esos son true or false y me lo mandan a mi número or in the chat. Do you have the book? ¿Sí tienen el libro?
Sí.
Ok, porque voy a ir a las otras salas a ver a sus classmates. I'm going to stop sharing. I can't share the book. No puedo estarles mostrando el book. So, eso, ¿verdad? En lo que nosotros terminamos las presentations.
¿Lo haríamos todos juntos o cada quien?
Solo serían... Tú, Lily, and Ellie.
Okay.
Solo ustedes dos. Individually, in okay. this case. But, let me check. Or if you want to, lo quiero ver. Las puedo enviar a un room para que lo hagan juntas. In that case, just accept the invitation, okay, that I'm going to send in this moment. Hi everyone, have you finished?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. So in that case, I'm just going to visit the other rooms really quick. I guess in 2 minutes we will be back. Solo tengo que ir a ver a sus classmates. En unos 2 minutos vamos a volver entonces. Okay, so see you in one moment.
North Shore is looking at candidate from manager. Him or her could be has requirement net. Una question, teacher.
Hi, yes, tell me.
El encabezado con compañero Luis. Si está bien conjugado him or her, él o ella. Así está bien.
He or she.
Him or her.
He or she. ¿Y qué es lo que hay, quieren decir en esa parte?
Sus requerimientos tienen que ser los siguientes, ¿sí? O sea, en ese caso, Norfolk is looking a candidate for a manager. Him or her. Could be as requirement
net.
Lo su de él y su de él, de ella.
Ah, okay.
Los requerimientos.
Well, in that case, you have to say the requirements. Requirements are the following ones. Quedaría así. The requirements are the following ones. Once with S.
One.
Okay, yes. Now we will go back in about 1 minute, okay? So I wanted to let you know that in 1 minute we will be back.
Okay.
Miss, excuse me. Hola, hola, tu micrófono. Okay. Solo quería hacerle un comentario en español.
Tell me.
La programación de las reuniones que se hacen después de la clase ya está definida. Por ejemplo, mi caso. No sé si está dando 10 minutos después de la clase. ¿Usa esa modalidad todavía?
Ajá, yes.
Tiene una programación para más o menos saber qué día me toca a mí.
Ah, ok. I'm going to send you a message. Voy a revisar y lo contacto. I will send you a message. Como ahí tengo sus números, le escribo, ok?
Ok, muchas gracias.
You're welcome. Ok, everyone, welcome back. I hope you are ready now. We will continue. Group number one, María Ivania, Nelson. Nelson, I think he couldn't join the room, right? Nelson creo que no logró llegar. Le mandé la request, invitation, y creo que no logró estar ahí con ustedes.
Teacher, también nosotros no llegó Carlos.
Carlos is busy. He's only listening to the class. That is why he was not there with you. Okay, so Ivania, Nelson, Oman, and Jenny, can you present the information that you understood about the article?
Hi, Nelson. No. The perfect manager. Be a people person. The company is looking for a manager who is social with the staff and who can resolve job problems and likes to work as a team.
Be a good communicator. A good manager must know how to listen and communicate the company, guidelines, motivating the staff, also accustomed to give period reports of the activities and their staff, the achievement and progress of the work.
Be technically proficient. The manager shall have defined objectives and guidance the personnel. If the manager hasn't defined the objectives, he cannot manage the staff. Also, he has identified and shared the abilities and qualities of each team member. The person manager shall be able to design the best strategies and methods for success. This person must have the knowledge, experience, and preparation to function in the professional field.
Encourage teamwork. The manager should be encourage teamwork. You are required to use practice for teamwork. If the manager does not have an office, should be working with his team.
Lead by example. A good manager must be an example. This appropriately professional be a counselor. Be the first in the company and the last to leave. Live with the employees' environment.
Only that.
Okay, thank you very much. It's a beautiful presentation. You have the pictures, different colors, and good explanation. Thank you. Thank you, Jenny, and Nelson, and Ivania. Okay, group number two, Rodrigo and Alfonso.
Rodrigo, how are you?
Yes. Northford is looking a candidate for manager. He or her could be has requirement at 41. Five requirement of the perfect manager. One, be a people person. A, the candidate should be comfortable with conflict resolution. B, to know how people work and know how to motivate your team. C, it's best the he use computer and understand that English.
Number two, be a good communicator. Letter A, to have effectively with communicate. Letter B, use visual presentation. Letter C, good public speaking. And letter D, use the internet, some Instagram, Facebook, and WhatsApp, another.
Number three, be technical proficient. Letter A, the show will be able to give technical guidance. B, decide the best strategy and method for success. C, they watch the movies for quality as technical.
Number four, encourage teamwork. Letter A, required to encourage the best practices for building teamwork. Letter B, considered a part of the team. Letter C, always the door is open. And letter D, is required to sit and work with your staff.
Number five, lay the example. Letter A, required to dress and act professional at our time. Letter B, guidance and help when needed. C, lady be a sample man. D, is necessary work late and weekend. E, use the same washroom and parking and not iron pontification. If do the right thing. Only teacher.
Only that teacher.
Okay, thank you, Alfonso and Rodrigo. We will continue with the next group. At the end of the presentations, I'm going to give you some feedback, okay, to all of you to improve a little bit more. Okay, but at the end, once we have listened to all of you. So now let's continue with Maria Concepcion, Mayra, and Oscar.
Okay, the best manager, requirement of the best manager, be a people. You should be comfortable with conflict resolution. You should know how people work and know how to motivate your team. If you are better with computers than people and understand Klingon better than English.
Be a good communicator. You should be able to communicate on effectively using admit medios, including visual presentation, public speaking, email, teleconference, and face to face. You will be required to routinely update your employees on your and the team performance. You will communicate any feedback from upper management and customers and provide status information when asked. Be technical proficient. You should be able to give technical guidance and decide the best strategies and methods for success. Does not qualify you as technical profits in Linux.
Teamwork is important. Not only are you required to encourage the best practice for building teamwork, you are required to sit and work with your staff. lead the example. The best manager lead the example. All managers are required to dress and act professionally at the times and to be available to give guidance and help when needed. Leading the example means working late and weekends with your employees, parking with your employees, and using the same washroom as your employees. Finish, teacher.
That's all, teacher.
Okay, thank you very much to all of you. And again, we will continue with the next group, and at the end, I will give you some feedback, okay? Now we will listen to Galileo and Wendy. Tell us what you understood about the articles.
Here I am. Wendy?
Okay.
Please go ahead.
The perfect manager. A people person is a person who likes to interact with other persons. So, Northall is looking for people who can motivate the team. If the candidate is better for whatever thing, but is not better to gather people, he is not going to part of Knoxford.
Be a good communicator to send any message, and the team can understand it clearly, and they can apply on the practice every single knowledge.
Be a technical proficient. All products created in Northall are complicated, so the candidate must provide guidance and method to success. He must be proficient in Linux.
Encourage team. The company consider every one person part of the team. Any people is excluded. The candidate must work with his staff and make feel well them.
A good leader must to teach to the team with his example, and he must to be available to give guidance and help when needed. The lead must work late or on weekends with his employees, so the lead must share every time in every place with his people.
Thank you,
Galileo and Wendy. I appreciate your participation here. Let's listen now to Elena and Anna. Elena and Anna.
Yes. Perdón. Se ve la pantalla, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Yes. By retaining of the perfect manager. Be a people person. Knoxdoor is people, and we are looking for manager who like people. You should be comfortable with conflict resolution. You should not hold people work and know how to motivate your team.
Be a good communicator. You should be able to communicate effectively using all methods, including visual presentation, public speaking, email, teleconferencing, and face-to-face.
be technical proficient. The product with strengths as Noctur are technical complicated.
Teamwork, encourage teamwork. Teamwork is important at Noctur. Not only are you required to encourage the best practice for building teamwork, you are considered a part of the team.
Lead by example. The best manager lead by example at Noctur. All managers are required to dress as professionally at all times and to be available to guide and help with the needed. Finished.
Okay, thank you, Anna, and thank you, Elena. And okay, we have one more group to go. Blanca, Laura, and Zaira. We will listen to you and then I will give you some feedback. Okay, sorry, Laura, perdón, usted me dijo de que no estaba ayer.
No, sí estaba Carlos ayer con nosotros. Ahora no estaba en el grupo.
Ah, but Laura no estaba con ustedes.
Sí, sí. También, somos cuatro.
Okay. Ah, okay.
Laura, Carlos, Zaira y yo.
Ah, okay.
Presentamos, teacher.
Yes.
Ah, okay. Okay. The perfect manager. Oops. We understand that Noctur is people and is looking for manager who like people. In addition, a manager should feel comfortable resolving conflict in the work team. Also, a manager must know how people work in order to motivate his work team. Noctur is not looking for employee who are better with computer than people.
Be a good communicator. We understand that we may be able to communicate effectively using all methods and that we may appear in public face to face and via email and that you have to update employees Austin.
Be technically proficient. We understand the Noctur are people technically. You do not need to be able to program in C, but you should be able to build technical guidance and decide the best strategies and method for success. You don't need to be good at computer. You need to be a good person in health.
Encourage to work. In work is important and also in work. Work with a group of people where we all have a common goal. Some of the qualities will be nice, allow to listen, acceptability and collaboration, assume responsibility. Lead the example. The best manager led the example in most dress and not professionally. At all times, we have arrived to help the needed. The manager knows work well and on meeting with his employee, but with his employee and using the same button and his employees. Finish it, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much to all of you. You did a great job. I know that it was difficult. And yesterday you were working very hard to complete the presentation. Okay, so you made it. And I have some feedback, okay? So for you to improve. First, I'm going to take the attendance because it's 9 a.m. So after I take the attendance, we continue with that. Ana Beatriz.
Present.
Ana Lilian.
Present.
Thank you. Blanca Elizabeth.
Present, teacher.
Brian. Javier. Carlos Antonio. Francisca Elizabeth. Frida Mejía. José Galileo.
Present.
Teacher, present. Francisca Elizabeth.
Yes. Thank you. José Rodrigo.
Present, teacher.
Laura Carolina.
Present, teacher.
Luis Alfonso.
Present, teacher.
María Concepción.
Present.
María Elena. María Ivania. Thank you.
Present.
Nelson Gavarrete.
I'm here. Miss.
Omar Francisco.
Present.
Oscar Villatoro.
Present.
Zaira Marleni.
Present.
Wendy Zabaleta.
Present.
Jenny Santos.
Present, teacher.
Cristian Lazo.
Present, Miss.
José Arnoldo. José Jonathan. Juan Carlos Rivas. Mayra. Mayra Moreno.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Now, let's continue then. By the way, Lily and Ellie, could you finish? Liliana, I got a picture.
Yes, teacher. I try.
Ah, okay.
No sé si está bien, pero intenté.
Ah, okay. I will read it after the class in that case to check it.
Es que no tengo el libro y tuve que escribirlo todo.
Ah, okay. Take a picture. Take a picture of it and send it to me.
Yeah.
And I will check it.
WhatsApp or Zoom.
By WhatsApp. Send it to me. Yes, Lily. Yes, I got yours. After class, I will have more time to check it out. Okay. Also, remember that today we finish unit number one. So we have to complete the homework on the platform about the problem. Ya reportamos el problema. Del ejercicio que estaba mal y que no funcionaba. Sin embargo, es un problema un poco como que complejo y los que trabajan en la plataforma no lo han podido solventar aún. Así que ahí con ese todavía estamos mal, pero con todos los demás, please continue with the other ones. Ese todavía no me han dicho que esté arreglado. Okay, so feedback about the presentations. First, let's talk about pronunciation. There are some words that I heard, the most common words. I'm going to say them 3 times, each one, and then you will say them, okay, to practice the pronunciation, the correct pronunciation. Okay, number one, encourage, encourage. Encourage. Number two, identify. 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 Okay. Number three, buy. Buy. Like bye bye. Buy. The same pronunciation. qualify. 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 Next, requirements. 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 Proficient. 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 Able. 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 Okay, that's the correct way to say it. Okay, let's go with the first. Mm-hmm. Yes, Laura.
La palabra que se escribe como guía, guidance, ¿cómo era pronunciado? Ah,
guidance. Guidance.
Sí, mm-hmm. Guiding. Okay,
correct.
Gracias, teacher.
Yes, you're welcome. Okay, so Maria, Ivania, and Omar, please repeat on the count of three. One, two, three. Ivania?
Encourage.
Continue.
Identify by qualify requirements proficient able.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Omar and Jenny at the same time. Vamos a hacerlo de dos en dos. At the count of three. One, two, three.
Encourage.
And Omar, are you here?
Encourage.
Okay. One, two, three. Number two.
Identify.
Yeah, identify.
Mm-hmm. Next.
Bye.
Bye.
Next.
Qualify.
Qualify.
Requirements.
Requirements.
Requirements. Mm-hmm. Next.
Requirement. Proficient. Proficient. Able.
Correct. Thank you, Jenny and Omar. Next, let's continue with Rodrigo and Alonso. At the same time, on the count of three. One, two.
Alfonso.
Alfonso. Alonso said. I said Alfonso. Recuerdo que dije Alfonso. Sorry, si dije Alonso. Okay, so Rodrigo and Alfonso, on the count of three. One, two. Three.
Encourage.
Mm-hmm.
Identify. By. Qualify.
Requirement. Proficient. Able.
Mm-hmm. Just proficient.
Proficient.
Mm-hmm.
Proficient.
Thank you. Maria Concepcion and Mayra, on the count of three. One, two, three.
Encourage. Identify.
By.
Qualify.
Qualify.
Requirement.
Requirement.
Proficient.
Proficient.
Able.
Able.
Uh-huh. Thank you, Mayra and Maria Concepcion. Okay, Oscar and Galileo, on the count of three. One, two, three.
Encourage. Identify.
By.
Qualify.
Requirements.
Mm-hmm.
Proficient.
Able.
Very well. Thank you. Next. Wendy and Anna. On the count of three. One, two, three.
Encourage. Identify.
Identify.
By.
Qualify.
Requirement. Proficient.
Able.
Okay, thank you. Only this one again. Identify.
Identify.
Requirements.
Requirements.
Proficient.
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 Yes. Okay. Thank you. Let's continue, Elena and Blanca. On the count of three. One, two, three.
Encourage. Identify. By. Qualify.
Requirements.
Proficient. Able.
Able. Thank you. Just this one, Blanca. Proficient. And requirement.
Requirements.
Yes. Requirements. Thank you. Mm-hmm. The other one sounded well. Let's go with Laura and Zaira on the count of three. One, two, three.
Encourage. Identify.
Identify.
By.
By.
Qualify.
Qualify.
Requirement.
Required.
Proficient.
Able.
Able. Uh-huh. The last one, able. Okay, able. Thank you, Zaira and Laura. And lastly, okay. Lily and Ellie. One, two, three. Again, one, two, and three.
Es que la primera
es encourage.
Encourage. Mm-hmm. Identify. Mm-hmm. By. Qualify. Requirement. Proficient.
Uh-huh. Enable. Thank you. I think Ellie is not there. So, but yes, that's the right way to say those words. And the other thing I wanted to tell you is how to use verbs. También quería hablar de cómo estábamos utilizando los verbos. When you were sharing the presentation, in some moments, you use the verbs. Cuando estaban en sus presentaciones, vi que en algunos habían puesto solo el verbo, right? Use, and then you mentioned the idea, use. This is an example. Use the right words. Okay. Y utilizaban los verbos. Okay. So I will teach you how to use verbs to start a sentence. Y esto va conectado con el review que íbamos a hacer. There would be. Would be. And could be. Okay, vamos a hacer el review. I will tell you in English first. I'm going to tell you this in English first, and then I will translate. Okay, just to make sure that we are on the same page. Would be. Mm-hmm. Okay, Zaira, when do we use would be or could be? ¿Cuándo utilizábamos estos? Do you remember, Zaira? The use of would be or could be.
I don't remember, teacher.
Okay, it's fine.
Como me gustaría.
But the use, when should we use it? Ivania and you, do you remember?
And
no, teacher. No, okay. Who remembers?
Teacher.
Yes.
Como que era una posibilidad
when,
real, algo así.
When we require something finally.
Is the modal verbs.
Okay.
Modal verbs.
Indicate okay. Possibility, imaginary situation.
Okay, you have the idea. Huh? You have the idea. Let's try to have that clearer. Vamos a tratar de tenerlo más claro para qué se usa. So you can try to use it. Okay, we use, vamos a enfocarnos ahorita en would be and could be. Okay, no va a ser solo would and could, sino que es would be and could be. The use to talk about a future possibility, something that could happen in the future. Para hablar de algo que podría pasar en el futuro, ¿ok? Puede ser muy real, ¿verdad? O puede ser tal vez imaginary, o tal vez es algo que imaginamos o quisiéramos, pero no sabemos si realmente pasará. But it's a future possibility. That's the use. Ok. Antes que le explique eso, voy a explicarle dos cosas para la estructuración, to structure the sentences. Okay, first of all, verbs. Let's talk about verbs. Y esto va relacionado con el exercise que estábamos haciendo en el libro, que se puso bien difícil, ¿verdad? Vamos a hablar de esos exercises. Okay, we can use verbs as subjects of a sentence. I will explain in English and then I will give you the Spanish version, okay? But we can use verbs as subjects, okay? As the person, we can say Blanca, Galileo, Wendy, or we can use a verb to talk about activities. And we have to put ing. For example, travel, and I'm going to use ing, traveling is expensive. I'm not talking about a person, I'm talking about an activity. Verbs can be the subject of a sentence. Vaya, no siempre vamos a tener como sujeto, ¿verdad? El sujeto es la persona que realiza algo. No siempre va a ser una persona. A veces puede ser un lugar, un animal, o puede ser una acción, podemos hablar de acciones. Yo no quiero hablar de mí, quiero hablar de viajar. Okay, si ustedes van a hablar de una acción, vamos a poner ing, le vamos a poner eso al verbo, ing, y luego hablan de eso. Example number two. Number two. Drink. I want to talk about drink and water. This is my subject. Drinking water is important. Okay, como no estoy hablando de un sujeto como persona, sino que es un verbo, it's a verb, tengo que agregarle ing y luego continúo la oración. Drinking water is important. O podrían utilizar un verbo. Drinking water, y voy a usar un verbo, ¿verdad? Porque drinking water no es un verbo ahorita, es un sujeto del que hablo. Has a lot of benefits. Drinking water has a lot of benefits. Okay, aquí está el verbo. Como es simple present, ¿verdad? Como es presente, tengo que hacer lo de la regla de la S. No sé si se recuerdan que le tenemos que cambiar la forma al verbo. Okay, I can talk about activities. Puedo hablar de actividades. Example number three. Run. I want to talk about this activity. But I have to add ing. Running in the beach. And now I have to say something about this. What could we say? ¿Qué creen que podríamos decir about running in the beach? ¿Qué podríamos agregar? Do you have ideas?
It's healthy and funny.
Ajá, okay. It's healthy. Wait. and funny. Okay, thank you. Entonces aquí está running in the beach, pero again, no es el verbo en sí, sino que es el sujeto, porque estoy hablando de esa actividad. Okay, are we good here? ¿Estamos bien acá? Or do you have questions about the ing, sobre lo del ing? Questions. Esto es para luego juntar todo, pero esto es como una de las bases. Okay, I'm going to continue. If you have doubts, tell me later. Let's talk about the verb be. Vamos a hablar del verb be. What is the use of the verb be? Wendy, do you remember? ¿Se recuerda qué le dije del verb be? ¿Cómo se utiliza?
Para adjetivo.
Ajá, to describe, okay, to describe things. What else? Don't worry, I will help you. Okay, el verb be, no sé si ustedes todos empezaron en nivel 1, pero igual se le olvida a uno, ¿verdad? En el nivel 1, ahí se hablaba sobre el verb be y el uso que se le da al verb be. Is there anyone who remembers? ¿Hay alguien que se recuerde el uso del verb be? Porque el verb be es como special, right? Es un poquito distinto a todos los demás. Is there anybody who remembers the use of the verb be? Ellie, do you have a comment?
Age.
Ajá.
Age.
When we talk about age, that's one.
Location.
Correct. If you want to talk about locations. If you want to talk about the weather, we use the verb be.
Weather.
Uh-huh. If you want to talk about the time.
Adjectives.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. We have to use the verb be with that. Examples. Age, edades, I am. Tenemos que utilizar el verb be, right? I am 28 years old. Locations. Lugares, localizaciones. I am in my house, right? Locations, I'm using the verb be. Okay, weather, to describe the weather, si quieren hablar del weather. How is the weather? The weather is hot, right? We use the verb be. In these situations, we use the verb be. Okay, en esas situaciones, utilizamos el verb be. Describe. To describe people, she is, okay.
Describe is adjectives.
Uh-huh.
Feature?
Yes.
Yes.
You use adjectives. She is ugly, she is beautiful, my dog is big, my dog is fat. To describe, utilizamos adjectives para describir. Okay, so now, vamos a combinar todo. We're going to combine everything. Let's imagine this situation. I say, okay, Elena, I give this comment to Elena. Elena, let's go to the beach on Sunday, okay? Let's go to the beach on Sunday. Le doy ese comentario a Elena. Okay, ahora podemos generar ideas. You can think about possibilities in the future. Okay, Elena, let's go to the beach. Maybe Elena says, tal vez Elena dice, going to the beach, porque esta es la activity, right? Going to the beach could be, would be, porque quiero hablar de un future possibility, right? Going to the beach would be Great. Ahora, si quieren hablar de alguien en específico, vamos a utilizar acá la preposición for. No es para duration ahorita, it's not about time. Es para un tipo de persona or population. Will be great for me. Okay. Going to the beach would be great for me. I'm very tired. I'm stressed. Going to the beach would be awesome. Amazing. Okay. And here I'm combining everything. Sorry, do you have a question or comment in this moment? Lily, do you have a question? No.
No
question. Okay, another example. Let's say this. Le decimos a Zaira. Zaira, maybe you will have a race. Maybe you will have a race. Let's suppose that I am her manager. Vamos a creer que soy su manager, Zaira. Y yo le digo, Zaira, maybe you will have a race. Tal vez le vamos a dar un aumento. Okay, what do you think, Zaira? Si le dijeran eso en su company. To talk about a future possibility. Maybe she can say. Okay, voy a hablar de una activity. Having, ¿verdad? Having a race, y ahora utilizo uno de estos dos, could be beneficial for my family. Okay, and I'm combining everything. Entonces acá estoy como juntando diferente gramática. I'm using gerunds, I'm using the verb be, and I'm using would be. It's like a combination. We're combining everything. Es un poco de cada cosa. There's a comment. Hay un comentario y ustedes, you imagine something in the future. Se hacen una idea de algo. Do you want to ask a question? Do you have a doubt? No sé si quieren preguntar algo. Galileo, no.
No, teacher. It's clearly. Thank you.
Better. Está mejor.
Better.
Okay. We will practice, okay? We will try to practice. Okay, so remember, if you want to mention someone, use for. Okay, for. Would be is the one you have to use. Would be. Okay, and sometimes, and this is something else, eso es algo más que pasó en ese ejercicio, having a race, yo puedo decir having a race, o puedo reemplazar ese sujeto y utilizar it, right? Porque estoy hablando de una cosa, de esa activity. It could be beneficial for my family. Okay, si ya sabemos de qué estoy hablando, para no decir todo, ¿verdad? Como decir having a race y hacerlo más corto, utilizo el it, ¿verdad? Que va a reemplazar esa idea. It could be beneficial. What? Having a race. Okay, entonces ya reemplazo. No siempre va a ser justamente una persona. It could be activities. I will share with you something here. Here you have two examples. Example number one, I, okay? Ahí sí hay una persona. I would be, pero como recuerden el uso de be, se utiliza con descriptions. I would be a great asset for the company. Example number two, I could be, and here you have the complement, of great help in the sales department. Okay, so that's the way it works. K, Can you try to create one sentence? Pueden tratar de crear una, please. One sentence. And you can send it in the chat or you can say it. I will give you like 3 minutes for you to share your idea. One example, please.
Who is the best teacher?
Sorry, Elena? You want the book? Ah, okay. Think about a situation, going to the beach, receiving an increase, a salary increase, going to the movies. Think about one situation and imagine the future possibility. You can use a verb or it could be a person.
Teacher.
Yes, Ali.
I want to say my I don't remember how you say your oration.
Sentence.
I want to say my sentence
me
corrige. I would be travel to Canada.
I would be traveling. Okay, that one. Traveling. Allí es otro uso de would be, it's correct, pero estamos como diciendo algo que, how can I say it without making it difficult? You are talking about a future activity, but okay, yes, it's like something that could happen, right? I would be. Is it like in the context of a possibility? Lo estás diciendo como en una posibilidad of the future.
Yes.
Okay, well, I think you don't have to use it like that. Ahí sería, I may travel to Canada. Okay, would be, Ellie, you have to use an adjective. Con would be tienes que utilizar un adjective. Good, excellent, great, big, un adjective tienes que utilizar. Como que te digan, I think you can travel in the future to Canada. And you say, traveling to Canada would be great. Would be great. Traveling to Canada would be great. So maybe you can say it something similar to that. Galileo, changing my car could be great for me. Thank you. It's correct. Who else is ready? Oscar, Laura, or Lily? One example.
Sure.
Oscar.
When visit other country, I will be know other language and culture.
But what are you trying to say there, Oscar? ¿Qué es lo que usted quisiera decir ahí? I don't hear you, Oscar. You are muted.
Ok, cuando yo visite otro país, ¿verdad? ¿Yo debería o podría conocer otra lengua, otra cultura?
Ok, thank you. Vamos a mezclar un poquito de lo que les mencionaba la vez pasada. Cuando es algo hipotético, ¿verdad? Algo que estamos pensando, imaginando, sí podríamos utilizar I would y un verbo. I would learn about a different culture. But if you use a verb, don't use the verb be. Si utilizan esta estructura, no vamos a utilizar el verb be, ¿verdad? Así que, ajá, sería así. I would learn or I would eat new food in this place. Mm-hmm. Who is next? And, ajá.
Me, teacher.
Yes.
It would be great to vacation in Brazil.
In France, yes, it will be very good. Uh-huh. Thank you. It's correct. Galileo, the second example is also correct. I could be a famous writer if I hadn't. Yes, Laura, that's a good example. Thank you. And Ivania, you can say, it would be good. It would be good to buy a car. That's the correct way to say it. It would be good to buy a car. Who else is ready? Elena, Mayra?
Yes, sí.
Ivania, ajá, Ivania. Ah, okay, well, you already did it here. Lily, it would be great to go, ajá, on vacations to Brazil. Practicing could be the best. Practicing, uh-huh, your English could be the best form to learn. Yes, Jenny, it's correct. It would be good to go eat pizza. Yes, Blanca, mm-hmm. It would be very good. I like Hawaiian pizzas, so I would like to eat that one. Mayra? I could be a good athlete. Yes. Okay, so those are very good ideas. Now we will try to do what we didn't do. Vamos a tratar ahora de hacer lo que no pudimos hacer la vez pasada por el tiempo. The presentation using this. Okay, we will try. Vamos a ver si nos alcanza el tiempo. Okay, here we have the exercise to apply what we're studying. Prepare a presentation about the benefits you would bring to a new company. Okay, prepare a presentation about the benefits you would bring to a new company. Vamos a hacer una presentación en la que hay una posibilidad de tal vez obtener un trabajo, ¿ok? Y ustedes tienen que hablar de qué le podrían ofrecer a esa compañía. Van a escoger esa compañía. Let's say it's Apple, ¿ok? ¿Por qué debería Apple contratarlos? Why should Apple hire you? Y ya pueden decir, I would be a great help with or designing, for example, designing cell phones or creating cell phones. If not, si no lo podemos hacer in the form of a presentation, hagan five sentences como grupo. Five sentences talking about that. Reasons why you will reasons why you will benefit the company. Escriban cinco oraciones de por qué la compañía se beneficiaría de tenerlos. Is it clear? Is the activity clear? Yes?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, so five sentences. If you want to make it in the form of a presentation, si quieren hacerlo como presentación, perfect, better, Pero si no, hagan 5 sentences as a group. You will be working with the same. Van a estar trabajando con las mismas personas. I'm just going to move Rodrigo to a different room. I will just make some little changes. Let's see. Okay. I'm going to send you the invitation. And I'm going to assign Lily in room number 5. Okay, Lily, you will receive the invitation in one moment. And Nelson, Nelson, ahí está. Do you hear me, Nelson?
I'm here.
Okay, Nelson, le voy a enviar la invitación. Espero que sí le llegue.
Okay.
Nelson?
Hello?
No le llega la, la invitation.
No, 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 no me ha llegado la invitation. No.
Pero no, no puede ser porque ya la envié. No sé por qué no la está recibiendo, Nelson.
Yo creo que tengo 2 dispositivos. Ahí está el detalle, creo. Aquí otro dispositivo.
Ah, ok. Revise ahora.
Ahora sí.
Ah, okay.
Lo que pasa es que ahí depende del departamento al que vaya también, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh. In my case, maybe the que actuality de a contact.
Prepare airport.
Ajá.
Uh-huh. Ella de
elaborate, ¿verdad? Elaborate, así que uh-huh.
Elaborate. 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 Uh-huh.
Report.
Yes. Y también podría ser como a control de seis venta, ¿verdad?
Sí,
mm-hmm.
Safe.
Hi, Ru.
Hi, teacher.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, teacher.
Elaborate pyro.
¿Cómo?
Elaborate pyro. Planillas.
Ah, ¿cómo se escribe?
Elaborate. Ah, planillas.
Planillas. Uh-huh.
La
mía.
Pi.
¿Cómo?
Pi.
Ajá.
No. Is A.
Ajá.
Es A, planilla. Ah, no.
No, ya está en Spanish.
I send that in the chat. Pyro.
Payroll.
Sorry, Jenny, just one question. Estas oraciones serían las finales, the final ones.
No. Ideas.
Ah, okay.
In the moment.
I'm going to show you ideas. I'm sorry, I'm going to stop the sharing a moment. Here we have this conversation. Aquí pueden ver más o menos como, como una idea de cómo sería. Okay, how do you feel about working in the sales area? Okay, I'm comfortable, sir. Y aquí está uno. With my experience, I will be, this will be a great opportunity. Question number two, can you bring, what can you bring to this company? I will be good at, y esta es otra opción para elaborarlas. I would be good at, y pueden poner un verbo, at making reports. That's another option. Algo en lo que ustedes se ven siendo buenos. Okay, entonces, aquí en esta parte de la conversation hay algunas maneras de elaborar. Okay. Page 11, ¿cómo I think it is.
How do you say, teacher, conocimiento del mercado?
Knowledge.
O sea, por decir, si es tecnología. ¿Cómo?
Knowledge of the market. I'm going to send it in the chat.
No. No, let's mark. Ah, okay.
Okay, so that's just an idea, okay? But continue. Yo luego les puedo dar feedback, okay? Pero sí, traten de ver cómo lo aplican, ¿verdad? El would be and could be. Yo también es un poco difícil, ¿verdad? Porque hay que pensar bastante en qué decir. Okay, well, I'm going to let you continue. I'll see you in a moment, okay?
Thank you, teacher.
Pues a mí me sale así, hazlo con, bueno, creo que lo mira.
Ajá.
No lo alcanzamos. You will earn for me high
school. You could... Cool, hire, no, pero no está el cool be. Vamos a ver. ¿Qué es la plataforma? ¿Qué es la plataforma? Sí, en la laptop.
Podría ser.
Eso era podría, lo, could be create new application.
Podría, ¿qué es?
Podría ayudar en nuevo.
It could be help.
¿Cómo?
I, sorry to interrupt. Excuse me. Eli, estaba viendo que ahora me tocaba la sesión de 10 minutos con usted. ¿Es posible que se quede hoy?
Sí.
Yes. Ah, ok. All right, I just wanted to check. Before I go, do you have questions for me? Do you need help with?
In una.
Mm-hmm.
Está bien, I would be creating new application.
I would be?
Mm-hmm. New create. Application.
Create, new application.
Create.
Create.
Say this, I would be good. Good at creating
apps.
At creating apps. I would be good at, or I could be. That's a second possibility. I could be good at creating apps or applications.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Yes. Any other questions? No. Okay, I'm going to visit your classmates, okay, but I'll see you in a moment then.
Okay.
Ajá. Solo que mire, siente que le puede cambiar el color a la letrita, hasta que usted mero choca.
Me
encanta ver un poquito.
Black.
Ahí, ahí, así ya. Ajá, ahí, sí ya.
Hi guys, okay. Is there something I can help you with? I'm just checking on you to see if you need my help. Do you have questions?
Todas.
Sí, estamos perdidos.
Ah, ok. ¿Cómo les ayudo? Bye. Recuerden de que la idea es que imaginen una situación futura y de esa situación, la situación que está acá es que van a ver qué le van a ofrecer a una compañía, ¿verdad? Esa es la idea. Lo que ustedes pueden darle. Les voy a dar unas ideas. But give me one moment.
For all, no sé si está correcto, ¿verdad? It,
la
it
que han
will
puesto,
be
sí.
Of, la otra es, it will be of great help in your company because I am a responsibility person.
Responsible. I'm a responsible person. Uh-huh.
It is correct.
Yes, it is correct. This is another possibility. I could be good.
In this uh-huh. sentence, don't use ing.
Hmm? In which this one?
Will be responsible. I could be okay, thank you.
Eso es como que ustedes creen que van a ser buenos, ¿verdad? Serían buenos en y ya ponen el verbo con ing. I could be good at y ya dicen la activity que podrían hacer muy bien ustedes.
Ah, okay, okay.
Teacher, y la que tenemos ahí anotada, la que está ahí está mala o está bien hecha.
Number
bueno,
one.
No, sí, no sería. Sí, esa que está, ajá. Solo que ahí en vez de fluency sería fluent.
No, ahí está ajá. Bien. I have a fluent level
ajá,
of English.
Acabar como era, ajá.
Only ajá. One change. I could be of great help. That would be the only change. Besides that, it's correct. Ajá. Of great help. En number two creo que está diferente a como la dijo María Concepción.
Sí, es
ajá. Ajá. But yes, creo que vamos a cerrar ya los rooms because of the time. Pero ya tenemos como tres, okay, like three of them. You still have 1 minute, okay, to finish typing. See you there in a few seconds.
Estoy ahí.
Uy, fue buena la incapacidad. Bo.
Y era que sí.
Hi everyone, welcome back. So now let's share the sentences that you have. If you only have 3 or 4, it's okay. We will start with. Let me take a look to the groups. Jose Galileo and Wendy, can you read your sentences, please?
Present teacher. Okay, Wendy, I'm gonna share my screen.
Oh, okay.
Okay, Wendy, please read it.
Okay. Oh.
Go ahead, Wendy.
Solution. No. Okay. What paragraph?
¿Puede usted ver mi pantalla?
Yes.
Okay, please read it. Por favor, lean.
We could be to sharing our experience about customer service. Also, we could be to train other people about faster service. Kindly attention and how we could be proficient and provide to the customer the better solution. Then the other company
could be increasing its client quantify as soon as the service has changed. That could be great to the company and could be benefit for me too.
Okay, thank you. It's good. You have combined different sentences to create it. At the end, you can say it will be beneficial. It will be beneficial for me too. And at the beginning, you can say we could share our experience about customer service. Let's
we make sure.
Mm-hmm. We could share. Okay, thank you, Galileo and Wendy. I'm going to stop the sharing. And we will listen to Blanca, Laura, and Zaira.
I would like to contribute my knowledge and experience to increase sales in the shortest possible time.
It will be
beneficial
because I have the ability.
The company would be complementing itself by hiring it with our sell skill.
Mm-hmm. Okay, very good. Thank you. Uh-huh. They look good. Thank you very much, Zaira, Laura, and Blanca. Okay. Because of the time, the others that you didn't share, please take a screenshot and send it to the group so I can read your sentences there. And remember the platform. If you haven't finished the homework, please do it. I'm going to take the attendance one last time before you guys go. We start with Ana Beatriz.
Present.
Ana Lilian.
Present.
Blanca Elizabeth.
Present.
Okay. Brian Javier. Carlos Antonio.
Present.
Thank you. Francisca Elizabeth. Frida.
Present. Mejia.
Okay. Jose Galileo. Jose Rodrigo.
Present.
Okay. Present teacher.
Laura Carolina.
Present teacher.
Luis Alfonso. María Concepción.
Present.
Okay. María Elena.
Present teacher.
María Ivania. Thank you.
Present teacher.
Nelson Gavarrete.
I'm here.
Okay.
Miss.
Then Omar Francisco.
Present.
Oscar Arnulfo.
Present.
Zaira, Larín.
Present teacher.
Wendy Maribel. Jenny Santos.
Present teacher.
Thank you.
Present teacher.
Cristian Lazo.
Present
teacher.
José
me. Arnoldo. Thank you. José Jonathan. Juan Carlos Rivas. And Mayra Moreno.
Present teacher.
Okay, thank you. Okay, guys, I'm going to stay with Ellie tonight in our private session. We continue tomorrow with all of you, okay? Nice to see you. Take care.
Okay.
Sweet dreams. Good night.
Thank you.
Good night.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
One moment, Ellie. We will wait for your classmates to leave and then we continue. See you, Galileo. Bye, Laura. Bye, Blanca.
Bye.
Bye bye. Okay, Ellie. Now we are alone. Okay, so Ellie, remember that this session is for you to tell me what you need. Aquí usted manda, ¿verdad? Si usted quiere un refuerzo de algo que hemos visto en la clase, podemos hacer eso. Pero si quiere que sea de otra cosa, puede ser de otra cosa. Así que usted dígame a mí en qué quisiera que le ayude un poquito.
De lo de la clase de ahorita, no sé qué estábamos haciendo.
Lo de would be.
Would be, could be. Después de would be, pone una, como un adjetivo, quizás, ¿verdad? Un calificativo.
Ajá, algo que describe, ¿verdad? Lo que es que hay diferentes como estructuras, ¿verdad? Es el que estamos viendo ahorita nada más es would be. Ese es el que estamos viendo ahorita, would be and could be. Pero hay otros que se pueden usar también, que algunos de sus classmates utilizaron, que sí se puede, pero digamos que en lo que ahorita estamos en el libro, no va. Entonces, aquí estamos utilizando, por ejemplo, un subject. Este sería como la structure general. Sería subject, would be, or could be, plus an adjective. Esta sería como la estructura, como el patrón, por decirlo así, de las oraciones. De ahí en adelante, lo que sigue después del adjective se puede modificar. Puede ser de distintas formas. Entonces, la idea, Eli, es que ustedes tengan un suceso venidero, algo de lo que hablar. For example, vaya, que yo diga, vacations are coming, ya van a venir las vacaciones, or December is coming, ya viene diciembre, y uno puede pensar en eventos futuros, posibilidades, y podemos hacerlo de diferentes maneras. I would be happy. Okay, esa es una manera. I would be happy. Y si quiero utilizar, por ejemplo, un verbo, I would be happy to go to the beach in December. In December. Okay. Y aquí estoy hablando de un evento venidero utilizando would be, que es la estructura primaria, por decirlo así. Y luego si quiero o si quisiera utilizar un verbo, hay que poner to. Can you try? Siguiendo este patrón, Eli, ¿qué podría decir? December is coming, siempre sobre diciembre.
I could be. No, pero es que le iba a decir podría cocinar, pero.
Ajá, va no un verbo.
Ajá.
Ajá, tiene que ser would be. Describir una emotion, una emoción. Y luego vamos a poner el verbo. For example, vaya, lo de cocinar. I would hate to, no, sorry, I would be excited to cook for my family. Y aquí está, pero luego del adjective, tiene que decir cómo ese evento le haría sentir. It will be great, it would be exciting try Deli. Mire si se le ocurre uno y vamos a tratar de elaborar.
Con add good line no se puede, ¿no? ¿Verdad?
Sí se podría, pero ajá, sería otra, otra
es cosa. Otra cosa.
Uh-huh. Y como ahorita, como le digo, vamos solo con would be and could be. Y luego, ese es el pattern, ese es la structure. Vamos a pensar en un subject, si soy yo o si es una activity. Y luego va el would be or could be. Apoyado o adjunto a una emoción, a un sentimiento. Luego
I
es...
Would love it.
I would love.
Encanta. Ajá.
Pero
love verbo. Es como encantaría. Ajá.
Pero sería un verbo. I would love. Y estamos utilizando ahorita como verbo be. I would be. ¿Y cuál sería la emoción? December is coming.
Ay, no, no sé, teacher.
Vaya. ¿Qué podría decirme? Si yo le digo, ya viene diciembre, ¿qué evento o de qué podría haber una posibilidad? ¿Qué le gustaría que le pasara a él?
Ay, nada. No sé.
Ajá. Ahorita no está, sé. Fue, se han bloqueado las ideas. Pasa sí. A veces que uno piensa y nada. Ok.
Digamos, me gustaría que me visitara de Estados Unidos.
Vaya, podríamos decirlo.
Pero lleva like.
Pero no, tenemos que decirlo de otra manera, porque eso es lo que estamos viendo aquí. Podría decir.
Me emociona.
Ajá, I would be extremely happy, y luego pone el verbo, to see, ajá, or, well, to see friends or family, from the USA. I would be, y luego dice cómo se sentiría por algo. I would be extremely happy. Y luego pone por qué. To. Y pone el verbo. O podría decir. It. ¿Verdad? De sería. Si no quiere decir de usted. It would be. Good. To see. My family. From the USA. Es lo mismo, pero ahora con otras palabras. Pero estoy diciendo lo que usted quería decir. ¿Verdad? Que le gustaría recibir visitas o a alguien de los Estados Unidos. Pero usted dice cómo le haría sentir. Vaya, es como que usted dijera, sería bueno, sería bonito. Sería, y luego dice, ¿cómo sería eso? Sí, esa sería como la manera de tomar el would be. Solo que yo usualmente no me gusta como traducir porque uno, no siempre todo va a ser literal, por decirlo así, ¿verdad? No es bueno traducir todo. Pero sí, would be es como sería. Ok, pero ¿sería qué? ¿Sería bueno? ¿Sería malo? Y luego decimos qué.
Pero estaba mejor traducirlo.
Con sería. Eso ya fue la clave.
Sí, ahí ya desperté.
Ok, sí, es como que diga sería. Pero no podemos solo decir would be, sino que necesitamos un sujeto, ¿verdad? Ok. Entonces, si es una cosa, utilizamos would. It would be, ¿qué? It would be good. Y luego ya dice la activity. It would be good to go to the beach next week. Can you try? ¿Puede tratar de hacer una, Eli?
I could be, pero es un sentimiento, ¿va?
Una, ajá, happy, sad, excellent, great.
I could be excellent to travel.
Ajá.
In my vacation.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Entonces, ese es el significado de would be. Pero a largo plazo, Eli, es malo traducir todo, porque no todas las estructuras son iguales. Entonces, la idea es aprender inglés sin traducirlo, sino como trasladar la mente, ¿verdad?, a otro idioma. Pero sí, es como would be. Es como sería, perdón, el significado de would be or could be. Ambos se toman como eso. Y ya usted dice cómo, it would be y un adjetivo. Okay, well, I'm glad that you got it a little bit more. Eli, I think that we will stop here. Okay, but we will continue tomorrow. Do you have any comments? No sé si hay algo que quiera decir antes que cierre la session.
No.
No.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay, you're welcome. You're welcome. Have a good night.
See you
tomorrow.